Hello everybody, Ben Larry here. Let me show you the latest development in my mental health software. It's going to end up with many different functions, but just initially I'm working on one function at a time. And this initial function is designed to help anybody who's at risk of not getting enough social interaction, such as self-employed people who spend a lot of time working alone at their computer. This is designed to assist those people. So you're going to do a daily log. You're going to log how much social interaction you've had. You're going to log your mood, all different kinds of things. If your interaction score drops below 4, this software is going to choose 3 random names from your friends list, and it's going to email you those names and prompt you to contact them, to arrange to meet up, to arrange to go to coffee, whatever. Arrange a phone call, anything. So it's just designed to prompt you. So last night I wrote the bit of code which sends the email. This morning, I received my first email. Let me show you. And it says, your interaction score has dropped below 4. Please message the following people: Julia Crocker, Nigel Howitt, Joey Bushnell. Now, I posted about it on Facebook and Julia saw my post. And Julia's a music manager. She's got a band that she manages. And she said, oh, you should come to the gig. We've got a gig on Friday. We've got a gig next week. Come along. So that's already instigated a social, okay? Nigel Howitt. I haven't spoken to him for ages. Let's message him now. Nigel, how are you doing? You are part of a social experiment. I've been writing a little bit of software that prompts me to contact friends. And I'm actually recording this right now. So I'll send you a clip to the video so you can see what I'm doing. Anyway, hope you're well. Loving the podcast. I really enjoyed the one with Corbyn's brother about the environment. That was awesome. Speak to you soon. Okay, so that was a message to Nigel. Nigel lives the other side of the country, so it's not very easy for me to visit him, but it's nice to stay in touch. He lives in Hertfordshire. So I've already spoken to Julia. I've spoken to Nigel. Let's send a message to Joey. Hey Joey, how's it going? I don't know if you've been following my stuff online, but I've been writing some software that prompts me to contact friends just to stay in touch. And the software threw up your name. It chose you. So I'm just sending you a quick message. By the way, I'm recording this. You'll see this on a video later. I'll send it to you. Hope you're doing well. I can't remember where you live. Is it somewhere near Birmingham? But I'll figure it out. And if there's a chance to come and visit or something, I don't know when I'll next be up that way, but let us know how things are going and we'll get something sorted. All right, bye. Okay, so I've made contact with 3 friends. Let me show you how this thing works a little bit. Okay, so by the way, I'm going to put this out so people can use it. Here's the friend list on the left. Here's the 3 friends that it chose. Now, if you see here, let me just zoom in a little bit. This is where I wrote, this is just what it sends in the body of the email. Your interaction scores drop below 4. Please message the following people. Name 1, name 2, name 3. And so if we go into the code, this is what the code looks like. And what it does, this is the little bit here where it takes that range in column 1. It generates a random number between that range, and then it returns the value in that cell. And then it takes that text from this cell, and then it replaces name 1 with the first name that it found, name 2. You get the idea. And then here's the little bit of code where it sends email. Gmail app, send email. There's the 2, there's the subject, and there's the email text that it then inserts. So I'm learning to computer program as I go along. Now, at the moment, I haven't integrated it with the thing where the interaction score triggers it. At the moment, it's just being triggered on a daily cycle. So 7 a.m., it runs the code. Here it is to get the random names. Ooh, next is going to be Andy Larder, Mike Mee Bishop, and Matt Greenwood. And then at 8 a.m., it triggers the code which sends the email. Let me just show you, actually, so you can see what I'm talking about. If you go into the... By the way, if any of this interests you, if you're in Google Sheets and you click on Tools, click on Script Editor, that's what takes you to this code editor section, right? If you click on this little time thing, this is where you can generate triggers. Okay, this is where I've generated the trigger. Down here on the bottom right, add trigger, and then you can set it to trigger the script at a certain time. Okay, so I just thought I'd show you how it worked. Now, so the last thing I need to do, I've got a video log. Now, this video that I'm recording for you now is my next episode, and I already wrote a bit of code where I can keep track of all my episodes. So I'm gonna add a new episode. It runs a script. I gotta give it a name. What should we call it? Friend prompter emails. Okay, I'll call it that. Now it creates a new episode number. It inserts the description into there. It combines them all. So there's my video title for this video. And once I upload it to YouTube, I put the YouTube link in there. So I've got a log of everything. Everything's organized, everything's tracked. So that's it for today. My next task will be to turn this into an add-on within Google Sheets that anybody can install. Because at the moment it's just code on my own script editor. But I want to basically turn it into an app that anybody can just easily install on their Google spreadsheet. They can put their friend list and it will perform this function for anyone. All right, thanks everybody.